Alright, hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder development blog video. This is not going to be an upcoming content video because this vehicle is now already in the game. The reason I'm still doing this is because this vehicle was supposed to be, in my opinion, one of the better additions with the most recent update, Hot Tracks, but Gaijin, I guess, had to rush the update out quickly and they didn't have enough time to do enough dev blogs. As such, they've done the dev blog on the ZTZ99 or Type 99 a day after the update had actually released. Well, actually, it was on the same day that the update released, but it was like 12-something hours later. So I'm still going to be covering it, but just as a quick reminder, the update Hot Tracks that this tank came with is already out and on the War Thunder International client, so if you haven't installed it yet, go ahead and install it, and then you can play with this tank, you can research it, buy it, whatever you want to do with it, it's there, ready to be played with. It is one of the most long-awaited additions to Chinese Ground Forces tech tree, the ZTZ99, now giving them finally a proper high-tier main battle tank, and giving them access to rank 7. So, let's talk about this exciting new addition. The ZTZ99 is a Chinese third-generation main battle tank developed during the late 1980s as a replacement for older MBTs in service at the time. The highly advanced ZTZ99 has arrived in War Thunder, reinforcing the top rank of the Chinese Ground Forces tree in the Hot Tracks major update. Briefly, it is one of the latest Chinese MBTs in service, featuring good firepower and mobility as well as sophisticated armor protection. The ZTZ99 is a main battle tank for China of the 7th rank. Pros are that this has excellent firepower, advanced protection, and low silhouette. Cons, however, are that it has poor reverse speed and limited gun elevation angles, which you would probably be used to at this point anyways for these style of MBTs, but that's fine as long as you're always moving forward and on flat ground. So here's some history on the unit if you are interested. Okay, and then we got some screenshots. So this is also one of my most long-awaited tanks ever since, when was the Chinese tree released? Yeah, I even forgot now. 2019, right? It was September 2019, I believe, is when the, when China finally made its way to the game, the international client, I guess I should say. And I think that this was one of the vehicles that was teased on their preliminary release tree to be coming soon. Well, here we are over a year later, and it's finally here. We slowly got an addition with like the 96 and then the 96A, and then of course now we get the 99. And I also just think that some of these vehicles look fucking gorgeous. The ZTZ99 I think looks absolutely stunning, as well as, like, for example, some of the Korean MBTs, which we don't have in the game right now. I think they also look really nice. I would like to see more of the, I would say, Eastern MBT lineups that some nations have access to. I mean, yes, I realize that the whole flavor of the month vehicle now is the Japanese Type 10, which I agree, even though in a previous video I had explained to stop fucking complaining about it in every single dev blog because it's going to do nothing but piss people off, like myself now, even though I also really want the Type 10. Just repeating the same thing in every non-related dev blog is doing nothing but getting on people's nerves. It has nothing to do with moving the development of the vehicle forward. There are threads for that. There are other places built specifically for suggestions. And even if they started working on it, it can take up to 6 months to build a single model for War Thunder. Though, to be fair, they could have had that model for the Type 10 already under construction for the past 3-4 months even, so it could be coming sooner than you think. That being said, though, I'm happy to see this. Hopefully we get to see some other variants of the 99 in the game at some point, but I think I'm very satisfied to at least finally get at least one of them right now. So they showed off in some of the different camouflages there. I do wish China would get a couple new top-tier camouflages. I do like this one, but I think that they could benefit from some of their other paints, such as their naval paint that you can see on some of their vehicles online. It's basically a blue and white digital paint. It's the only digital camouflage you would ever see me use. And I think it looks fucking awesome. So in War Thunder, the ZTZ99 is the new top-performing main battle tank at rank 7 of the Chinese Ground Forces tree compared to the current top-tier Chinese MBT, the ZTZ96A. The ZTZ99 brings with it a whole host of improvements, strengthening the tank's combat efficiency overall while not introducing any radical changes to its core design. Following on from its predecessors, the ZTZ99 comes equipped with a 125mm smoothbore cannon featuring comparable ballistic properties as well as a rate of fire as those guns found on these familiar ZTZ96s. Additionally, the ZTZ99 also comes equipped with some of the standard advanced MBT equipment such as thermal vision, smoke launchers, and laser rangefinders. Although firepower only sees a marginal improvement over preceding vehicles, one aspect of which the tankers will almost certainly feel a major upgrade is protection. On its own, the ZTZ99 already comes equipped with a thicker composite armor solution than previous vehicles, meaning tankers will see a notable increase to protection against both chemical and kinetic ammunition. However, the ZTZ99 is fitted with additional ERA protection, which further improves its resilience to enemy fire. And then here we've got some more screenshots with some of its other camouflages. Fucking gorgeous looking tank. There's its ass. I mean, that profile there. I just love the shape of the turret. I think that's really what drives me insane with this tank, is the shape of the turret. It's like they took Russian hull design, but then came up with an even better looking turret design. And then that's what makes it just look fucking gorgeous. And of course, it's got a mounted machine gun, because it needs one of those. While the protection offered by the ZTZ-99 increases significantly, so unfortunately does its weight when compared to the ZTZ-96's. Despite this, the ZTZ-99's mobility, instead of decreasing, actually improved. This comes as a direct result of the vehicle being outfitted with a more powerful 1,200 horsepower diesel engine, allowing it to reach a respectable top speed of 65 kilometers an hour on roads, while also maintaining good mobility even on less hospitable terrain. On the other hand, the ZTZ-99 did inherit the rather poor reverse speed of its predecessors, being able to duck back into cover only at a pedestrian 4.5 kilometers an hour. As a result, tankers are well advised to thoroughly think through every action before committing to it, especially those which have them weak, break solid cover and potentially expose themselves to enemy fire. So, yep, it was introduced already. It's in the game now. You don't have to wait any longer for this thing. It's there. And I'm sure it's going to make a lot of players who play the Chinese tree very, very happy. They also got a new AA vehicle, China did, which is like a rank 2, I think. It's got a quad 50 cal on it. It's just a truck, but at least they're finally getting a little bit more there. Now all they need is their rank 1 AA vehicle, and they'll finally have a somewhat good AA lineup, with the exception of a SAM unit, which they don't have anything like that yet. I don't think they do. I believe they stop at the WZ-305, I think. Right, or whatever that the ZSU-57 Chinese variant is called, which, yes, is different than the Russian version. If you actually look at their hulls, they're very different. Not very different, but there are differences to spot there. I think that's where it ends, which, as far as AA go, that thing, in my opinion, is not a good AA vehicle. I mean, it has a shell that can penetrate over 150 millimeters of armor, and it has a low fire rate, but a high velocity, and you're fighting against jets. So, of course, people are going to use it against tanks.